Tom Brady with all his Super Bowl victories. Listen, Tom Brady's witchcraft Super Bowl. That's the topic of today. I'm your host, Stevie Garofalo. Welcome to another episode of Reason for Truth. Listen, Tom Brady said publicly that he and his wife, Gisele, their faith in their witchcraft here, or he literally said, helped him in the Super Bowl. In sharp contrast, the Bible tells us in Leviticus this: if a person turns to mediums and necromancers, whoring after them, I will set my face against them. That person will be cut off from among his people. Leviticus 10:6. Speaking to the Israelites there, not just any people, including Gentiles, but I think the in principle we could say that, listen, that's going to happen. Listen, those, you know, were God's exact words to the Israelites in the book of Leviticus, as we just read. And how come it seems that Tom Brady has so many Super Bowl wins? Man, he's got so many titles, seven of the Super Bowl. He's attributed with seven Super Bowl victories. Listen, more than any franchise in the NFL, he's been the top guy, topping six, won by the Steelers and Patriots, and now won by Florida, Tampa Bay, right? Buccaneers. Unbelievable. He's got the Super Bowl MVP award and seven rings, big golden fat rings, probably with a lot of diamonds in them, as this Florida Tampa Bay Buccaneers beat Kansas City Chiefs 31-9 in this last Super Bowl. But for Tampa Bay Buccaneers, was their first Super Bowl victory since 2003. Why? All of a sudden, magical. Look, Tom Brady shows up. Is it magic that the Buccaneers won as soon as Tom Brady assumed the position of quarterback for simply, listen, being a man who's gifted in football? God gifted him with that ability, did he not? Skill and opportunity to become the most dominant quarterback in football history. Listen, welcome to where the truth comes first and the reasons come last, but we're always and constantly learning. Why? Because when we stop learning, we stop teaching, or at least stop teaching well. Today's truth is that God's given skills, or skill, ability, and opportunities has allowed Tom Brady to win seven Super Bowl football games, right? Or tournaments or victories. It's not witchcraft. Tom and his wife Gisele accredited their success dangerously to playing with the occult. Trusting in witchcraft for their success is playing, it's playing with the world of the dead. As a consequence, witchcraft and the occult has and will continue to widen a gateway for Satan and his demonic world to control the heart, mind, and soul of both Tom and his wife and their family if they continue on their current trajectory or path. Today I'm going to show you that what the Bible says about witchcraft. We're going to do this in a two-part series. I'm going to do one today, and then I'm going to do the second one next Tuesday. Thursday we'll cover something a little bit different, break it up a little bit. But listen, so we'll do that. Today I'm going to show you that the Bible says about witchcraft and the occult in light of Tom and his wife's temporary, and I see that word, temporary success with Tom's football career. Some people listen and say, Tom's been successful his whole career and he's about to retire. Temporary, he's still young. What does temporary mean, right? Temporary means here on earth. It's tempting to say or to think that Tom and Gisele, that their faith in the occult and witchcraft have actually delivered them victory for eternity when their victories are actually temporal. Like I just said, looking at the facts, right after Tom Brady led his team to win the seventh Super Bowl, which was his first with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, the Daily Dot published an article on February 8th, 2021, and that was updated February 9th, by the way, day after 2021, at 3:26 p.m. Central Standard Time by writer Phil West. And it was entitled, Did Tom Brady's Witchcraft Habit Help Him with the Super Bowl? Brady's wife, Gisele, and her name, last name is Bunchken, was quoted as saying to her husband, that is, do your work, I do mine, said good witch Gisele Bunchken. Now, bottom line is, see, she considers herself a good witch, and what she's saying to Tom is, listen, you work out, do all the things that you need to do, humanly speaking, I'll do the witchcraft part, and together, listen, we're going to find even greater success. But let me now provide you with some talking points, really help clarify what's going on here regarding Tom Brady and his wife, Gisele, and their faith in witchcraft. But listen, before I even say or get into that, I like Tom Brady, great quarterback, I like his family, nice people. I'm just really addressing, not from an angry perspective, but just looking at, really, they're gaining a lot of attention or giving a lot of attention for witchcraft, and I bet there's a lot of witches there going, hey, yeah, listen, yeah, you're right, it works, right? Did they try it? And you're dealing with the occult, and listen, that's what we're going to talk about today. talking points. First talking point is that witchcraft is a practice, by the way. It's not really religion. It's a practice, really, much more than a religion. Tom and Cassell, they're really New Age secular humanists, and they're actually religious pluralists. You know about that. I wrote a whole book on that called All Roads Don't Lead to Heaven, right? Discovering God in the New Age. It fits this exact subject very deeply. There's people who subscribe to religious pluralism. What religious pluralism just basically says is that all roads, all religions, or all religions, religious leaders, they all lead to the same spiritual place, same heaven, right? You just different kind of modes to get there, or different ways, different religions, right? This was made clear in an interview, by the way, that Brady gave back in 2015 by the New York Times, in which Brady said that his family has space for multiple faiths and said the following: "I think we're into everything. I don't know what I believe. I think there's a belief system. I'm just not sure what it is." Listen, that's number one. I want to say that Tom Brady and his wife and their family are really New Agers, and that they are, I'm not certain they know really what they believe. I think they use witchcraft as a practice, and they supernaturally, listen, some people don't walk under ladders or break mirrors. That's kind of the same line of thinking here for superstition, but it's not necessarily a religion in and of itself. If it is, it's secular humanism and New Age thinking, which we're going to talk about second. The New Age movement is greatly built upon a modern version, by the way, of ancient religion known as Hinduism. You know, most people from India, 80%, are Hindus. See, CBN article, Christian Broadcast Network, cited a report by USA Today that Brady kept a 4-inch bronze idol of the Hindu god Ganesh in his locker. Now, if you don't know, Ganesh is a very famous religious holy idol. Now, if you also, little qualification here, in Hinduism, there's over 330 million gods, and they're growing. You can always add one to it if you don't like what's available to you. That's a different discussion. But he kept this god Ganesh, at least this 4-inch or 6-inch, Brady kept this 4-inch bronze idol of the Hindu god Ganesh in his locker, obviously for what, good luck or to help him. You get that? The Hindu god Ganesh. Now, he's a famous, again, idol, which is widely worshipped throughout India and throughout Hinduism. Now, this idol is said to be the remover of obstacles. In the Catholic religion, a lot of times, they have different saints that do different things, which is not correct, by the way, either. But here, the same thing, where you have basically an idol, a thing, a dead person or an animal, or just a self-made idol. And in this case, that idol is Ganesh. Ganesh is supposed to be the idol that is the remover of obstacles in the Hindu faith. And this would account for Tom and Cassell's bended knee to the idol Ganesh to do what? To remove competition or the competitive edge that someone might have on him, or anything that might be considered an internal, right, within the organization, or external obstacle that might interfere with Brady's success. This talking, you know, point shows that clearly that Tom and his wife are really, I believe, New Age humanists who see Tom's natural abilities and God-given gifts as well as opportunities as something of his own doing, as something of his own strength, and maybe even possibly supernatural strength, right, that Ganesh or someone else gives him supernaturally through this witchcraft potions or whatever. That's number two. Number three is, if Tom Brady's success can be attributed to witchcraft, he's really not that good of a quarterback to begin with. You have to admit the logic goes there. It has to be witchcraft and not Tom's discipline, or at least even if it's 50-50, if he's half as good as what he is, he could be beat by most other people in the NFL. So I'm not taking anything away from Tom, because I think it is his ability. I don't think it is. I think he is that good of a quarterback by natural ability, by his discipline, the practice, and that's his God-given gift for sure. So listen, it has to be that witchcraft and not Tom's discipline, skill, and natural ability is what's causing his or giving him his victories, if you're going to attribute that to witchcraft. That's the bottom line. That's number three. Number four, I would submit that Tom's success is temporal. Whether that means temporary within this lifetime or, which, listen, anything could happen. Tomorrow it all can be, you know, over. We never know. We know there's no guarantee for tomorrow. The only guarantee we have is this moment we're in right now, and that could end 1 second from now. That's just the bottom line and the truth. So whether that means temporary within this life again or on earth, or temporal within the spectrum of reality regarding eternity, life is temporal, success is temporal. Just because Tom and Cassell believe in trust in their lives and the success of this witchcraft practice, does it make witchcraft true, or the truth, or the reason for his success any more than one's faith in Jesus Christ makes it true that Jesus is the Son of God or that Christianity is the truth. The truth is that God is real. Jesus is the Son of God, and God in the Trinity created man and woman in their, it means a Trinity, in God's image, meaning that God in the Trinity's image, right? Animals don't have that. Only man and woman are created in God's image. And in turn, Tom and Gazelle have made themselves, within their minds and hearts, a little God, and a small g, that is, small g for small God, right? Not capital G. Through the help of potions or fake idols that don't really exist outside of cultural beliefs of witchcraft, right? And it's just wishful thinking. Bottom line is that God made mankind. And listen, Tom and Gazelle and all the rest of us, if we tend to worship anything above God, have been returning the favor ever since. In other words, God created mankind, womankind, in his image, and we've been returning the favor ever since. This is very much illustrated here with Tom and Gazelle. Listen, they're returning the favor ever since by way of evidence of their worldly success as, again, being very temporal, and they're giving success to themselves. There is, in other words, I'm the great creator. God is not really real, and these potions are working because I have the power of these potions because I'm a good witch. That's their thinking. But the Bible's clear in Galatians 6, verses 17 and 19. I'm just going to give you little bits and pieces. I'll give you the full thing later. And really that the acts of the flesh are obvious. And it goes on to say, including idolatry and witchcraft. It gives a lot of other sins, but it's I wanted to point these out in this particular verse. Idolatry, that's making idols, right? Ganesh is idolatry. It's worshiping or looking for help from this Ganesh, right? To remove obstacles. And it says very specifically what here in the Bible? And what? Witchcraft, right out of scripture. Listen, I warn you, as I did before, that those who live like this is a scripture, will not inherit the kingdom of God. In other words, Tom and Gazelle are acting in the flesh and really against God. The entire verse names many other sins, as I said, and I will recommend you read all of that. It's in Galatians 6, verses 17 to 19. It just gives a whole list of sins. These are amongst them. To get a full understanding and proper context, go read that. The point is that idolatry, the worship of anything above God, including Hindu idol Ganesh, and listen, anything else, this witch potion and ourselves included, has not, will not, and cannot help Tom Brady win any Super Bowl game. So next week, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take the success of Brady's career. I'm going to compare it against Acts 8, 9 to 13 verses, which offers a parallel story, I believe, in many, many instances. We're going to break that down from the scriptures. I'm not going to break that down in this episode, but I'm going to go ahead and read it for you now, just so you get a little taste of what we're going to talk about, so you don't have to go look it up. It says this, Acts 8, 9 to 13 says this, but there was a man named Simon who had previously practiced what? Magic in the city and amazed the people. Just the way Tom Brady amazes the public. But he amazed the people of Samaria, saying that he himself was somebody great. They all paid attention to him, from the least to the greatest, saying, this man is the power of God that is called great. And they paid attention to him because for a long time he had amazed them with his magic. But when they believed Philip as he had preached good news about the kingdom of God, that's the truth, in the name of Jesus Christ, they were baptized, both men and women. Even Simon himself believed, and after being baptized, he continued with Philip, and seeing signs and great miracles performed, he himself was amazed. Acts 8, 9 to 13. You don't want to miss that episode, man. I'm amazed at Tom Brady, by the way. Talk about being amazed. I'm amazed that Tom Brady and his wife, Gazelle, are so amazed by themselves that they reject the God of the universe who created them and gave them the abilities and the skills and the gifts. But having said that, let's be praying for both Tom and Gazelle and their children. You know, they seem like a nice family. A lot of people are just misled about the truth. And listen, and we just pray that to be hungry enough, they would be hungry enough to embrace the true God, to seek the true God of the universe as found within the pages of the Bible through prayer and the power of the Holy Spirit. Listen, you don't want to miss that next week's episode on Tuesday. The way you do that, very simple. We're going to go ahead, give you something different on Thursday, but so you don't miss anything, go ahead, reach down, smash that subscription button, and then you know what I say, bam, the left hook, man, less Sicilian hooks. What do we do, Sicily? Bam. Go ahead and knock that little alert bell out if you're watching on video. You know what's going to happen? I always say, can't guarantee if Vinny's going to come out, you know, with a bucket of, you know, small bills or a pizza. That I can't guarantee you. But as I always say, go down to Luigi's or wherever's a good Italian restaurant. Everybody's got an Italian restaurant in their neighborhood. By the way, there's a reason for that. Italian food is delicious. I'm just saying. Maybe I'm partial. Make sure you do that. A couple of important things. Again, smash that that subscription bell and give the old Sicilian left hook. You'll be glad you did. Though. Listen, in closing, I want to leave you with an overall perspective regarding Tom and Cassell's faith in the New Age thinking and in themselves and in the witchcraft by which they're practicing. Trusting in mediums through tarot cards, palm readers, fortune tellers, and necromancers are really they're being misled and walking in dangerous ground. And that goes for everybody. I know, I've seen good people I know say, oh yeah, we went down with the girls or whatever. We got our palms read. Man, you're playing with the occult there. This is amplified for those who seek to influence the world against the truth of God through their own platform. You know, listen, that's what I see Tom doing. They're pushing. They want to make sure you know that witchcraft, they think, is helping them. What is that doing? That's only helping the practice of witchcraft. Well, I guarantee you there's thousands, if not millions, of young ladies, especially fastest growing religion amongst young high school females, is witchcraft. But that's only helping to promote that. So again, to promote that platform through his platform is very dangerous. Now, finally, I'd submit that Tom Brady and his wife, Cassell, are playing with the world of the dead in the face of God. The devil allows for and helps in the short run to take care of your soul, gives you some victories if he's able to within his power. And in the final Super Bowl of life, though, listen, before eternity, listen, at the end of the day, Satan won't get you there. He's going to pull you down. God's the one that lifts you up. So you got to know where to put your trust. I'm reminded of the character, Reagan McNeil. You never remember that name? She played, that was her name in the movie, but it was played by actress Linda Blair in the 1973 movie Exorcist. Now, I was a kid. That was scary. I went and looked at a little clip of it. I don't care what's come out with all the scary movies. That one still is the scariest. It's just, you do it to make sure that you're of age and that you watch it in the daytime. If you do it before you go to bed, you're probably going to be, you know, shaking under your sheets when you go to bed. I don't recommend that. But Reagan, playing this young girl, was simply entertaining herself and her friends. You know what she was doing? She bought a game that you can get online. You can get on Amazon. You can get back in the day when Toys R Us was open. You go right into you can go get it at Walmart. She's playing with the Ouija board. What did that lead to? She and her friend putting a belief in the Ouija board. Why things moved around on that. I've spoken to people who have actually seen the things on the Ouija board move. Okay, so to believe in the Ouija board, you know, as Reagan did in the movie, was an occultic, demonic, she was playing with the occultic, demonic world. And that led to the opening of her heart and mind and soul and belief, and almost in a sense, a faith in the dark spiritual world of the dead and the demonic world. And what had happened? It led to her being possessed in the movie by the devil or the evil spirit, right? And she became possessed, I guess, by the devil, as people say. Just as there are gateway drugs like marijuana, which leads to more dangerous and addictive drugs, such as crack cocaine or whatever. Listen, the same thing is true with the occult. You start small, you work your way up. Most people who are in the craft of witchcraft start with what they call them dabblers, the little stuff, then they work their way up. I'd say that Tom and his wife, a little bit more than dabblers. But playing with witchcraft and the occult is a gateway to the dark, demonic, spiritual world. You don't want to open that door. Hope you're going to think about that. Share this broadcast with others, especially where we're being broadcast around the world and all continents, where witchcraft is very real. Witch doctors are very real. A lot of places that we're speaking to. Listen, and this has to do as well with the New Age movement, and witchcraft is growing and the New Age movement at rates that are pretty alarming, including your own community. Guarantee it's there, maybe within your children. Ask them, they'll just get real quiet like that, see? And especially, again, amongst young high school-aged girls. In closing, let's remember that witchcraft is rebellion against God. In Galatians 5:19-20 says this. I'm going to read the full verse now. Now the works of the flesh are evident. I only gave you a couple last time. Remember, it was witchcraft and idolatry. But let's read the whole thing again. Now the works of the flesh are evident. Sexual immorality, impurity, sensuality, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, fits of anger, revelries, dissensions, division, and then there's some other ones. I won't even go because there's so many of them. Such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. Galatians 5:19-20. We need to ask ourselves, what exactly do we want to inherit? What are we worshiping? A lot of people today worship sex. But what exactly is it that we want to inherit? an eternity void of God, a world left behind with, listen, with all these giant, one day Brady's going to die. He's going to leave, listen, what's he going to leave, these big Super Bowl rings, put them in a museum, and then what happens if his kids decide to melt it down and, listen, make some money and go live at the beach for a year? I mean, those things can happen, and then what happens, right? What a legacy. And that's true of all of us, by the way. For what? A misled faith. Or do we want to inherit the kingdom of God? The choice is simple, I believe, and the choice is clear for Tom and Cassell, just as it is for you and I, for everybody who may be listening and that we know. And that is, let's put our faith in God, not in the demonic world, not in witchcraft, not in Ganesh or any other false god or idols. That wraps up today's episode, so please do me a favor. Leave some comments below. I promise I'll respond within a very reasonable amount of time. If you want a more in-depth online training, hey, listen, we now have, this will help you strengthen your faith, help you share your Christian faith in an increasingly new age, really anti-God society in our modern world. Please check out our new online training academy at equippedacademy.com. Or you can just go to reasonfortruth.org, reasonfortruth.bible, hit the Equipped Academy tab. If you're listening on podcasts or by way of video, please subscribe. And on that video, make sure you give the left Sicilian hook. Vinny will be proud of you. Hit that alert bell down after you subscribe. Make sure you tune in this Thursday. I'm going to give us a little break from the witchcraft before I pick it back up next Tuesday. Don't want to miss that. So again, subscribe, alert bell. But next week, what we're going to do is we're going to look at a comparison again of Tom Brady and his wife, their situation to that Bible story we just read earlier. You can also go back to did a couple past episodes on Tom Brady and his wife and witchcraft. May want to go back, check that out on our YouTube and podcast channels, and you won't be disappointed there if you do. She says she's a good witch. I'd say there's no such thing as a good witch. No one of us are good, but there's certainly no such thing as a good witch, okay? You find that again in other resources at www.reasonfortruth.org or reasonfortruth.bible. Appreciate you tuning in. Listen, thank you for joining me today. Till next time, I'll see you for the next episode of Reason for Truth. I'm your host, Stephen Garofalo, and this is your Reason for Truth for today.